Hi guys, today we're going to be talking about our 5 kilogram Extreme MIG 180 amp machine. It's a multi-process machine, can do MIG, can do stick, and can do tick. We're going to start up and show you the setting for stick. You would need an earth cable, but before you go there, you need to put the function over onto stick. Negative, earth piece. You will then in turn clamp this on your workpiece. Then you've got your electrode holder, which will go into the positive. You'll notice there's a slot on the DINS plug, on the male plug, where it slots into the female plug. And you'll put your electrode, your stick welder, or your electrode rod, welding rod, and then you can weld 2mm, 2.5, whatever you want to weld. Depending on the thickness, you would adjust the amps. If you look on the three dials, there's a function that says stick welding adjustments. You would adjust that. Moving on to the MIG setting, you would take your cables out. And yeah, you'll move over to the MIG. Then you activate these two dials over here. You will still need to use your earth, and depending on what wire you use, you get a solid core wire and you get a flux cord wire. If you're welding with solid core where you would need gas, you will take your jumper lead over here and you'll put it into the positive for solid core wire. You would then take your negative, put it onto your workpiece. You then in turn, and you'll open up this flap and you will put the wire on the inside, your solid core wire. You will take your torch, which comes with the machine, and you'll put it into this Euro slot. Okay, once you've done your magic and fed the wire, go through the torch, you are now ready to weld with solid core wire. Remember, you must always use your gas with solid core wire. When you're using flux cord wire where you don't need gas, you would need to, same setup, but change your polarity. And you would need to put this in the negative. And now your earth goes into the positive. That's MIG done. Got an extra function on MIG. You got this 2T and 4T switchover. In 2T mode, basically you would weld more like normal, pull the trigger and you'll weld. When you stop pulling the trigger, the weld stops. In 4T, you would activate it, it's basically like automatic. You'll activate it, you got your workpiece here, the wire will continue running until you deactivate it. That is 4T. Then we go on to spot welding. Spot welding, you activate this third dial over here. You can adjust it to whatever seconds you need it to arc welding, especially on thin materials when you need to tack weld or arc weld certain jobs. You would activate it. Depending on the time that you've put over here, you would need to, it will run for that weld time and it will stop. Whether you keep your finger on the trigger or not, you would run for that time. Then we go over to lastly, when we finish with that, we go over to TIG. TIG function. Again, you'll just put the switch in the middle. How you connect it, you will take your earth off and your jumper cable or that you don't need. With TIG, you would need to also reverse the polarity in your negative and positive function here. So you'll take your TIG DINS plug on the cable. You'll see it comes there. That goes into your negative. This goes directly to the gas bottle. And then your earth would go into your positive, and that's how you do it with this particular machine.